would visit the three imperial sanctuaries.
I see. So we are seeing the emperor once again about to enter the sanctuary. And as you mentioned, Osama, earlier, that no cameras are allowed inside the sanctuary.
No,
it's all private.
So it's private, yes. Here is Kashikodoko.
There we see Emperor Naruhito go into one of the sanctuaries on the palace grounds. This one is called Kashikodokoro. Now we're going to take a look at what events are coming up later today. In just a few hours, the Emperor will proclaim his accession to the people of Japan and to the world. NHK World will have full live coverage of this main enthronement ceremony. Now, a motorcade parade was originally scheduled after the ceremony, but it has been postponed as the government focuses on the recovery from Typhoon Hagibis. And later this evening, there will be a court banquet. Let's go back to our senior commentator Osamu Takahashi for more insight into what we saw earlier. Give us more information on what led up to the Japanese government deciding to postpone that imperial procession.
Well, officials basically said they need to give priority to those still dealing with the aftermath of the natural disaster. As you know, Typhoon Hagibis brought powerful winds and heavy rain, killing at least 82 people. Rescue crews, including members of Japan's self-defense forces, are still trying to locate missing people. But emergency crews are busy delivering food and supplies to those struggling to cope.
Now, how have the emperor and the empress responded?
Before the postponement was announced, Emperor Naruhito and Empress Masako expressed condolences for the people who lost their lives and sympathy to those who lost loved ones and were affected by the disaster. The imperial couple also said they are praying that people's lives will return to normal as soon as possible. And that's really in keeping with the emperor's history of comforting the Japanese people following disasters.
And tell us more about what we can expect from this afternoon's main event.
The event is called the Sokuirei Seiden no Gi. It's being held in the state room called Seiden Matsunoma at the imperial palace. And the emperor will proclaim the accession to the people of Japan and to the world. But first, the emperor will deliver a statement from the ancestral Takamikura throne. Then the prime minister will offer words of congratulation and lead the crowd in three bandai calls, the traditional cheer at celebrations.
And the history of this event dates back centuries. What should we look for to get a hint of Japanese tradition?
How different is the costumes? Especially those worn by Emperor Naruhito, Empress Masako, and Crown Prince and Princess Akishino. The emperor will wear a reddish-brown robe called the Korozen no Goho that can be worn only by an emperor. There is a theory that its color represents the sun. It's believed that the robe has been worn by emperors since the 9th century.
And tell us what other people will be wearing.
The imperial family members have traditionally attended in heavily layered ancient court costumes. But we will be seeing something new this time. Tailcoats and long dresses have been added as easier options in consideration of elderly members.
Okay, a lot to look forward to. Osamu, thank you very much. And Osamu, you'll be joining us throughout the day, so look forward to having you back on. And that does wrap up our special coverage for the first of several events today, the ritual in which the emperor reports to the sun goddess, the souls of his ancestors and various deities that the enthronement ceremony will be held today is still ongoing. Keep track of the latest through our website as well. Just scan the QR code on your screen or click the enthronement proclamation banner on the NHK World Japan News website. There you can get an in-depth look at all the events planned for the imperial family on this historic day. More events will be taking place at the Imperial Palace throughout the day.